Hey guys, and welcome to my encounter with Satellite Rain. Now, I'm actually reviving a format of a show which I did a long time ago, which is my encounters with things, which basically is a first impressions sort of blind gameplay demonstration. And the reason why I'm doing that is because, well, let's plays in general take way too long to make, and I'm starting to get access to a lot of games which I'd love to show you, but if I were to do a review on them, it would take forever to do so many, and also let's plays are too much of an investment. So I thought, let's revive the encounters sort of format, and I get to play a bit of a game, and basically I'm gonna load up the game for pretty much the first time after I make sure the game actually runs, and I'm gonna play through up until the point where I feel like, well, I've basically shown enough. So this is Satellite Rain, and it's sort of like a squad-based tactical futuristic RPG-ish sort of thing, and it feels a bit like XCOM, but let's go ahead and log into the game and I'll show you how the game goes. Alright, so let's go ahead and create a new user here, and user details, GamerZakh, of course. Game mode options, I'm just gonna leave it at default, but looking at it, it looks like we've got Iron Man mode, where Agent XP is reset upon death, uber damage, increasing the damage dealt by all units, and real time with pause. Start with full team stims, drastically slows time down when activated. I'm just gonna leave it at default, which is all turned off, which it says is for normal mode. Select a company logo. Okay, we've got some nice choices here. Something that matches me. I kind of like this one. That geometric shape. I think from my channel design, you guys know I like geometric shapes. And company color. I always pick the one that's closest to teal because that's my favorite color. This isn't quite teal. It's a bit more turquoise. Not quite aqua. But it's greenish blue. I like greenish blue. Now let's initialize connection. And establishing connection to satellite, and ooh. Yes, the aesthetic of this game is very sort of hacker, futuristic, data, all that sort of stuff. So let's see. Initializing satlink, okay, loading modules, SLS dev module.
At cybernetics pioneer, Dracogenics is making headlines with what they're calling instant consciousness transferal technology. But many are already referring to it as resurrection
tech. Investors are scrambling for a piece of Dracogenics. The list of wealthy donors has increased, with celebrities and politicians from around the world jumping on board. The ResTech satellite network has expanded globally, making Dracogenics a household name
allegations
overnight.
Allegations swirling today as rivals accuse Dracogenics of trading immortality for political influence. Federal authorities are called to investigate.
Continuing civil unrest today following the privatization of city services. Dracogenics security forces clashed with rioters all through the night.
Dracogenics CEO Stephen Dangler was exonerated today as the newly appointed judge dismissed the charges, calling them, quote, frivolous and unfounded.
Dracogenics have nobly provided their own private security force to assist in subduing the last stubborn holdouts of the city's poor and desperate. They announced the offenders are safely confined to the lower levels of the city where the conflict...
Dangler responded today to claims of a new threat from a shadowy corporate rival. Answering a call to action from stockholders, Mr. Dangler denied rumors of ResTech secrets being stolen in an act of corporate espionage.
And this just in, we're hearing that city police have apprehended a suspect related to the wave of recent anti-Dracogenics attacks. City security forces have the suspect now in custody after a gunfight with police that left several...
Okay, comms are a go. Hi, I'm your company contact, providing mission intel and support. Call me Tag. I'll supply data to assist with side jobs. But remember, our overall mission here, breaking Dengler's monopoly on ResTech and taking the authority and power it gives him. We're running a ResTech system ourselves, but it's flaky as hell. Its range is limited to our relay beacons, and there are no long-term backups. So if you lose an agent, don't wait all day before hitting upload. It's not perfect, but it might just give us the edge we need. We've re-established a signal with one of our agents, but the others are scattered, so first thing we need to do is to reassemble the team. Voice comms will be minimal for most of the op. Communications are heavily monitored in the city, so encrypted text is our most secure way of keeping in touch. I'll open up voice channels again when necessary. Good luck. You're gonna need it. Tag out.
All right. So I like that sort of intro. It's very quite a simple intro. I do have to say the voice acting for just in general newscasters and stuff like that, it sounds better than active aggression voice acting. But OK, let's see. We've got an agent here, and press F when agent is selected. Focus on the agent. Okay, zooming in and out, no problem. Let's see, press 1 to select the agent, and we can tell it to move here. Sprint command, double click. Sprinting will drain energy, which is the yellow bar. Okay, and to take cover, yes, this is here we go. We can take cover behind chest high walls, really. this sort of positioning and cover based system, it's quite tactical, XCOM sort of thing. And click the weapon button to reveal the fold-out. That's the weapon button there. Okay, select weapon. We'll take the Uzi, I guess. And we're gonna kill this guy. All right, looks like we got the upper hand. Taking some damage. Okay, so works pretty much straightforward and seems like we're completely overpowering that guy. And there we go. Don't forget to put your weapons away after you're out of danger. Click this or press space to toggle. Okay, there we go. While we're here, let's actually, since we're going over the controls, let's check the controls. Let's see. This is the interface. Okay, mission control, research, loadout, log. This is our current character. Okay, system. Okay, here we go. Options. Controls. Okay, there's a separate button. Okay, let's see. Seems like everything is pretty much rebindable. Okay, yes, we can rebind everything. All right, nice. Now, how do we... there we go. Okay. So, select one, move here. Okay, there we go. It looks like the door is locked. You can try to open it by using the terminal. This thing, disable security system. Okay, double click, run over there. Okay, so this is where the hacking comes in. What's this flashing thing? Alert level. Oh, basically you've got like 4 stars. Okay, that's fine. Looks like we can loot this thing here. Did this drop from the guy we killed? I think so. The door's... Do we have to rush over? I think we might have to rush over. Let's see if we can do this again. We've got to run through the door before it relocks. Okay, there's a timer on it. Let's go. Okay, nice. So the warning indicator shows when you are doing something you shouldn't be doing. Your agents are currently in a secure area, but we're trespassing. Okay. Move to cover, stay out of sight of the camera. Okay, so there's a security camera. So here we got some stealth elements. Try not to shoot out cameras if you want to avoid attention. Someone will be sent to investigate what's gone wrong. All right, nice. And seems like we just have to make sure we stay out of the light. Should be easy. If you're seen by cameras or enemies while you have a warning indicator, reinforcements will be called. If reinforcements are called, your alert level will increase and more enemies will be sent to your location. Okay, makes sense. And we can now move on through. Okay, this looks like a good spot to deploy one of our relay beacons. Relay beacons serve as a connection point to upload your consciousness if an agent dies in the field. Oh yes, this is what that company, GamerZakh, is that the name of the company? Something about an immortality system. Once we have all our systems back up and running again, they'll also let you re-equip your agents. Okay, so let's do this. And here we go. So this is basically a save point, I'm guessing. Oh, there we go, we've got someone new. I've sent in your support agent. The support will keep your agents working together. You can select either agent by their corresponding keys 1 or 2. Okay. Or you can select all your agents with Control A. Okay. Let's move on. Alright, so that's pretty cool. Now what's this? This door is locked. Do we hack this system? Disable security system? And will the door unlock? This door appears to require two terminals to unlock. You'll need some help. Locate the other terminal using the world scan ability. Is that Y? Oh, this is cool. Click again to deactivate. So we've got to send someone over there to do that. And you... So you can actually see how everything's connected in the world. This is nice. Okay. All right. And two, go hack that. And select everyone. And once the door is open, we can run through. There we go. Got one guy through. That's a question. Let's test something. What if I leave a guy out here? Did they actually consider this possibility? What if I get stranded? Is this sort of a main override terminal? I just want to see if they actually considered this possibility. I'm pretty sure they did. This game seems pretty well made. Yes, it's fine. Okay, here we go. Another patrol. We could take him out, but we could try slip past him instead. Stick to cover to avoid being seen. Okay, so basically when we're going from cover to cover, they stay crouched and they sort of stay out of sight here. Okay, so it's good to keep an eye on his patrol pattern here. So we need to get over there. Now, how do we slip past him? How does he walk here? He walks down this way. I'm sure there'll be plenty of combat in the future, so I just want to see if I can actually stealth by this guy. Was he coming around here? Okay, let's just follow behind him. Wait for him to turn the corner. I wonder if running alerts him to our presence. No? Okay, we're pretty stealthy. Okay, looks like we can go through that door, and it's like a teleporter to a new level. Okay, nice. Okay, so far this is looking really good, and I have to say, look at the world, look at the colors. It looks absolutely gorgeous. These colors here, and even the color I chose for my company, it reflects on my characters, so that's very nice. And it's just surprisingly beautiful considering it's sort of trashy dystopian future sort of thing. Okay, so now what are we doing from here on out? All right, with your weapons away, you can waltz right through crowds of civilians without causing a panic. There's something different about this terminal up ahead. If you select the terminal, we can see what you need to get past. It looks like this terminal has higher security on it. It requires an agent with level 1 hacker ability, someone like our hacker agent. The hacker is inside this complex awaiting extraction. One of the civilians around here should have security access to the complex. We should identify the civilian and bribe them to get our agent out. Use the world scan ability. Okay, so it says here, hacker level required 1. Okay, so world scan. Looking for a civilian with... Oh, there we go. That's our target. Bribe them to get the security codes. So we just bribe 50 bucks. Okay. Oh, there's our cash in the top right. We got a security key, and let's go get our hacker agent then. All right. So, do we actually go in the building, or is this sort of like a terminal sort of... Oh no, okay, it's a terminal sort of thing. Okay, fantastic. We have a hacker back. Oh, we can actually... I just also sort of instinctively selected this RTS style, but turns out you can actually select by drag and click and hold, dragging and clicking. Fantastic, we have a hacker back. Get the hacker to unlock the door. So, okay. 3 is hacker. We also have a hijack ability. Okay. All right, we've gone through and we've got another save point. Relay beacon location. All right. The hacker managed to find a silencer while waiting for us. There's another spot for a relay beacon up ahead. Get it up and running so we can equip our agents. Okay. Let's see, main menu here. Loadout. Okay, weapons. Select the pistol. Currently we're on this first person here. Do these people have names? I'm not too sure. Okay, we've selected the pistol. Select the pistol augmentation slot. And we can select the silencer, which costs 300. So we've found a schematic that we can augment our weapons with. Okay. And we can purchase for 350. Okay. Now, do we actually Do these people have names? I don't think they have names. Is it just... clone? These are clones? Della Hayes, Daryl Doppio, Aya Quadren? They kind of have names, but these are under... Is this person called Della Hayes? Oh, I think that is her name. Okay, Della Hayes. Alright, that's fine. Okay, now how do we back out of here? Okay, none of your agents are equipped to use this zipline yet, but we can still force them to interact with things like ziplines, terminals, and hardwire points. It's a risk, but there doesn't seem to be any other way out of here. So, if I could have sent someone else to hack that terminal, but it would be dangerous, I guess? Maybe they... it could explode, I guess? Alright, hold Alt to force use. So Alt plus right click. And they'll use the zipline even though they're not qualified to use a zipline. Okay, looks like your hacker had a bad fall. Your agent isn't out of the race yet. Get one of your other agents to get the hacker back on their feet. Alright, and is there a health regen on this? 70... 74? Okay, there is health regen. So we're doing okay. Alright, that's pretty cool though. You can actually force agents. It's not sort of hard sort of coded that, oh, you cannot interact with this. So this is hacker level required 1. So let me try something. Let's take my non-hacker, this guy, and I'm gonna force use on this. Can this guy hack this? Oh, okay. So it's not good. Okay. Uh-oh. Die? So that sort of alerted them to our presence there. He's shooting us through the door. Die, please. Sorry about that. Okay, so it is a risk in more ways than one. Looks like another guy's coming here. And we're gonna have to deal with this guy. Is he gonna run by? There's a dead body there. Okay, so it is a risk in more ways than one. Die, please! Anyone else? You gonna stop coming? Okay, I think we're good. No, this guy might be coming through. And you're dead too. Okay, so I think we're good. We're doing okay here. All right, so I think now we can proceed as normal. Okay, so sending a non-hacker to access a system is definitely a risk. Okay, let's loot this thing here. Now let's go through. And let's stay in cover here. Seems like we've got a few guys wary of our presence here. Can we sneak by? Okay, so it said something just now about guards. Let's do a world scan here. And there's some sort of purple terminal over here. And it seems like these guards have sort of prepped themselves over here. So let's see if we can sneak around. But we'll keep our weapons at the ready just to see what we can do here. Now let's do another world scan. Okay, there is a security camera. It looks like this disables the security camera. Okay, it seems like those guards have gone back onto their standard patrols, so maybe we could sneak over here once they move through. Okay. I think we're doing okay here. Alert level 1, weapons out. If we take off our weapons, it says... Okay, it's still alert level 1. Alright, now, this thing here, disable security camera system. Yes, please go do that. And will that alert them at all? No? They're okay with it? Alright, that's good. So where are we heading actually? We need to get through this door. Okay, we can sneak up to there. And seems like they've moved on. So let's move here. Disable security system, please. And let's get through this door. Okay, so we had some combat there. Our stealth mission was not so stealthy, and here we are in downtown. Let's put our weapons away. Alright, systems are starting to come back online. I have mission control back up and running. We are heading deeper into the downtown district. I have a few things I need you to get done, but it's up to you which ones you want to tackle first. I want you to set up some relay beacons around the district, and probably most importantly, we have the issue of our captured infiltrator to attend to. I've set up entries for each of the Project Satellite Rain dossier. Check Mission Control for more info. Mission Control, okay, it's here, Mission Control. Project Satellite Rain, rescue infiltrator. Infiltrator's been nabbed. Bastards holding all prisoners in a transmission blocking cell without transmission access. There's no way we can... Okay, purchase information. Surprise, surprise, we found a dirty cop. If we pony up some cash, he'll spill his guts about a few security blind spots. $100? I think we can afford that. Let's purchase information. Okay, money well spent. According to our contact, there's a secondary entrance on the western side of the complex with an unlocked door that's mostly ignored and half-assed security at best. Also, there's some leftover crap from a construction project from a few months back. Heavy cables that never got any electricity pumped to them are still anchored to a building on the southern edge of the complex and anchored up high. This would give us a great way over the fence if you've got the right gear, or if you're just willing to take the risk of a three-story drop. Right, okay. Once we're in, things might not be too hard. Almost any of your agents should be able to manage the rest of the operation. Okay, activate ping. Police station. Okay, so we're breaking into a police station then. Alright. So, let's there's a nice save point here. Okay, autosave successful. So, the police station, can we actually just look over there? Things get a bit foggy, but... Okay. So, let's move on out. We've got to save our infiltrator. It's this way, I think. What's this? There's someone sleeping on the ground there? Cannot hardwire, requires hardwire skill. Okay, I'm not gonna force it. Now, where is this? We're trying to get into this facility. Oh, here we go. Here's a zip line that was talking on the southern edge of the building. Okay, let's hacker level required 2. Okay, we don't have hacker level 2. How do we get over there then? We need to get to the other side. Can I just click here? No, okay, they cannot find a way. If we cross this bridge, this sort of seems like a really... Oh no, it does lead down there. Okay. Head over here. I wonder if we can level up their stamina so we can actually run for longer periods. Ooh, we're in business. Okay, all right.
Right, we're in business. The company's got me all set up to help us take Dengler down. His control over Dracogenics gives him control over ResTech, and his control over ResTech gives him control over everyone who wants it. I helped smuggle an older version out of their R&D labs, and we're going to use it to keep your agents in the field despite casualties. But that's a short-term fix. Long-term, a benefactor has supplied us with a virus that we can use to take control of his ResTech satellite systems. Ultimately, our plan is for you to get into Dracogenics' main tower to install the virus directly into their hardware. Right now, though, we've got to build up our company's presence here, working on getting you all the gear, money, and tech that we'll need to make that final assault, because I don't think they're going to let us just waltz through the front door.
Right, okay. So, this ResTech seems like a nice respawn mechanism. At least it sort of gives a... Can we walk this way? We got to walk here. Let's run. Okay, so, it seems like this is quite sort of company-based, like you're running a company, and you're sort of like a rival company to Dracogenics. And it is very sort of commercial. Look at this, there's ads everywhere. Megaco Pizza. And there's probably a few top-notch cherries. It is sort of a very commercial world they sort of set up here. Look at it, clean cash, a big dollar sign. These big sort of billboards and stuff like that. It's very cool. We've got to cross a road. Do we have to use the pedestrian crossing? Let's run into traffic. Okay, the cars do stop for us. Okay, that's fine. What's this thing? Hacker level required 2. It's an ATM. Potential siphon amount. Oh, we could siphon money out of a ATM if we have hacker level 2. Okay, that's pretty cool. Now, we were heading up here. So this is sort of leftover construction equipment. Ooh, we could scan local data caches. And this is gonna send us into the police station, which seems like there's a guard right there. We gotta be careful about that. But we're here now. Let's scan local data caches. What does that mean? And new message, the rise of the Dengler. Is that? What is rise of the Dengler? Would it be in our log? No? District downtown, relay beacons. I'm not too sure where that is. Oh well, never mind. Okay, we gotta alt to force use this thing. And we should be okay. That guy's over there right now. But I expect we all... Okay. One guy made it. Well, I guess one guy's gonna have to do it. Okay, let's see if we can actually do this single person. Now, this guy... It did say almost anyone can manage it. Who made it through, actually? This is our... This is not our hacker. Is it our hacker? I think it is our hacker. Yes, it is our hacker. Okay. So, we're in here, and I guess this is to open the door. We probably don't want to walk through the door, but I think this is the thing that we're going for. Okay, so this is pretty cool. You can actually leave a couple guys out of here. Carrying prototypes. Prototypes acquired. Now we gotta get to safety. Okay, once the agent is out of danger, the prototypes will be safe. So we've now got this fourth person, the infiltrator. So we've got a hacker and infiltrator. Soldier and support are left outside. Is there any easy way out? We could hack open this door, because we can't go out this way again. There's guards. Okay, can we... World scan is... he's over there with our support guy. Okay, so this is a little tricky. We've got a guard here. We've got a couple security cameras, which we might be able to sneak by. But first we've got to... Okay, we can hack this door open. Here we go, we've got our hacker. Uh-oh. They're coming. Let's just run through. Oh. Okay, so hacking that system sort of alerted them to our presence, but we managed to run away just in time. Very close there. Let's take cover here. And I think this is the door that the leaked information told us about. Where it was like this unguarded door on the northern end. Here we go. Very nice. Ah, that was pretty clean. Well, there was a bit of a moment of panic there. All right, excellent work. Looks like the band's back together. On the way out, our agents also got their hands on a prototype weapon. It's up to you. You can either send it off to the research and development department and try to mass produce the weapon, or you can give it to one of your agents right away. Be warned though, we only have one prototype. If your agents are killed in the field with that weapon, it could be tough getting our hands on another one. Okay, it's a Hauser TR machine pistol. Okay, let's go up here. Research. And we've got this Hauser TR, and here's some stats. Accuracy 50%, damage, magazine size, respawn time addition, time to completion, 15 minutes, total cost remaining, 2,800. That's quite a lot. But I guess We currently don't have much in the way of company funds. It would probably be best to pause the research for now and resume it once we have knocked over the bank or installed some ATM siphons around the city. If we're rolling in money later, we could always research multiple projects at once or put some extra researchers on a single project. Okay, so we'll pause because it'll cost 2,800 and I don't think we're earning any cash right now. All right, next mission, I guess. We've got to find a researcher. Okay. For logistics and tech support, we're going to need some researchers of our own. Okay, we'd get a great start on our own little tech division, except that the chief I've got in mind works for another core. The good news is that we know she's unhappy there. Any decent bribe will do it. Okay, so it looks like we've got to bribe someone who's over there, I think. Okay, we reported sightings of Sparks grabbing something to eat down at the Golden Mile. Use your world scan ability to find her. Okay, easy enough. And let's select everyone and let's regroup in front of the police station. Okay, oh, I was sort of scared that I'm gonna have to fight dozens of police officers. But here we go. At least we didn't have to go through, we could have gone through the front door, but that would have been a really bad idea. Let's cross the road. Cars stop automatically. Where's our other... Where are they? Wait, are they running through the police station? What are you doing? This is... No, wait, what? I guess we can't just tell people to walk around. Pathfinding was really bad. I'm gonna see if I can reload that. Because this is really bad. Alright, here we are back in front of the police station with everyone outside of it and not being shot and caught. And the autosave was kind of interesting. It autosaved after I got out of the police station with my infiltrator. But it sort of reloaded me back at the original spawn point of this area. Never mind. Our progress was still saved. Anyway, let's go find... We've got that arrow in the top right here. Let's try not to have our characters just auto-move there. Let's actually... Ooh, look at that! An animated advertisement of some sort of sexy lady. Wearing heels, no less. Okay. and with the words noir on the top with these scary-looking eyes. This seems to be some sort of red light district. Looks like we are sort of going through this red light district. It's quite a long ways to find this person. Where is this person? It's all the way over here? Wow, okay, that's quite a long ways. But I really don't want to just click my squad to move over there. Because it seems like they have no problems walking into restricted areas in their pathfinding. But never mind, the CSA is here, City Surveillance Authority. Now how do we... This is... Let's not walk into the Surveillance Authority, that seems like a bad idea. Is this whole area, looking at the map, it is actually colored red. Is there a way to walk around this place? Let's go here. And please don't walk through the Surveillance Authority. Okay. Okay, I think we can walk down this road and then we've got access. Okay. New dossier available. Can we... What's this? The City Surveillance Authority. Oh, okay. Downtown CCTV cameras... Okay, so it's sort of a quest to mess with them as well. All right, never mind. We're not gonna mess with them right now. We have a researcher to bribe. So, but it is sort of a long ways away. So I'm just gonna head on over there and see what we've got. All right, here we are entering the Golden Mile. So our researcher should be around here somewhere. So let's activate our world scan here. Now, where is our researcher? Now, it said she tended to have meals down here. Oh, there we go. Target found. Is that our target? bribe for $100. You're a bit more expensive, huh? Okay, let's bribe you. Researcher successfully bribed. Very nice. Okay, cool. And that's that. She'll get our research and development team running smoothly, and she's just the start. There should be lots of other eggheads and geeks around the city with all sorts of specialties. Let's work on recruiting whenever we can and get them on our side. All right. So, seems like the tutorial phase is sort of over, but I guess we've got... What is this? Two science, I guess, we've got there. All right, so let's go back to mission control. We've got the researcher. Next mission here is under Project Satellite Rain, find fresh clones. Cool, our new researcher friend says the cloning bays are back online. Clones allow replacement bodies for our agents, a somewhat brutal but necessary act if we are to succeed. Once you've scanned a civilian, you can select them and divert a small amount of resources to obtain a deeper scan, giving you info on their DNA traits. Once you have a target, use your hacker to hijack them. Oh, that's what the hijack ability is. Your clones will degrade after each cloning procedure, so you'll need to acquire fresh resources to keep your agents at their peak, or just keep your agents alive. The markets are full of potential targets. Activate ping. Markets. Okay, it's just over there on the other side of the CSA. Okay, I'm gonna head over to the market then. This cloning mechanic, it sounds a little confusing, but I guess the tutorial section isn't quite over yet. Let's go figure out the cloning stuff, but I'm gonna head over to the market first. All right, here we are entering the market. It seems like it's called The Pit, and it seems pretty aptly named. So we're here, and we're supposed to scan for a potential target, I guess? I only see security. I don't see any civilians. Okay, it says, wait. Let's select this guy and see what information we can get for a little extra money. Which guy are you talking about? Oh, this guy? Select the civilian. Okay. People who live downstream from the rich are, from the rich and healthy, know they've got it bad. Okay, so Mr. Jonas Erickson. Purchase extra info for $20, okay. Increase health regeneration, increase speed, and increase health by 5. Okay, he looks like a good candidate. Let's hijack them and send them back for cloning. It's this guy? Yeah, Mr. Jonas Erickson. Okay, so I'm guessing hijacking means sort of capturing them. And I'm guessing that's illegal, so I probably shouldn't be doing it around all this security. Let's wait for the security to not be around, I think. We're just gonna have to follow him around and wait for him to go down sort of a dark alley. Now, how do we actually hijack? Oh, it's here. V for hijack. Current cost 0% energy regen. Okay. Now, there's still a lot of security around here. Just look at all these guards. This is totally not suspicious. Four guys following this one guy down the street. Not suspicious whatsoever. All right. If he walks out of this area, I think we're gonna be okay. What guns are we all on right now? We're all on some sort of submachine gun rifles and stuff? Okay. Okay, he seems to be leaving this area. I don't see any security around anymore. Okay, let's try hijack him. Oh, there's civilians running away. Are they gonna call for help? I really don't know. And got him. Oh, we've actually got... Oh, he was added to our squad. Oh, here we go. Oh, look at that. We almost got caught by these guys. All right. All right, this looks like a good candidate. Okay, and what's this say here? We can return for cloning, unhijack, or show hijacked info. Okay, so it seems like we hijack people to absorb their stats, I think. So it's telling us here to return for cloning. Okay, and he's gonna run off. Jonas Erickson returned for cloning. All right, let's check what that means. Loadout. We've got Jonas Erickson here. Okay. Source stats are immediately degraded once applied. Okay. So, wait. Currently, Hold on. No. Okay. We can select our character. So currently we're selecting our soldier. And these are available clones. Okay. So Jonas Erickson. So we're currently using Della Hayes. This screen lets you change each agent's clone and customize their appearance. Clones come with small varying bonuses for your agent, but be warned, the cloning process is not perfect, and each time you clone someone, their bonuses will degrade. Okay, so current stats of Della Hayes here, which is assigned to soldier, is none. So if I select Jonas Erickson, it'll get 5 plus health, plus 2% speed, and 0.05 increase in regen per second. And apply the current selected clone. So we're applying Jonas Erickson to our soldier slot, I guess. And so this is our... So Della Hayes has... These characters have worse stats. Okay, currently it's Jonas Erickson. Okay, and we can even change the company color from here. That's nice. Headwear, color, main default. Okay. So does that mean... Our soldier is now a dude. Okay, so we actually swapped out our character for Jonas Erickson. So Della Hayes is still there, but okay. Can we actually... Oh, and okay, looking at other characters, if we look at Jonas Erickson, okay, then stat bonus is none. Okay, so that's a bit of a strange feeling. It means, well, I guess you don't form an emotional bond with any of these characters because you just sort of swap them out for anyone you go ahead and hijack out there. All right, let me just check what the next mission is supposed to be here. And is that the end of the... Okay, Project Satellite Rain seems to be completed. So that's the end of the tutorial, I guess. And I suppose that's a good point to bring this video to a close. I think you guys have seen enough. Satellite Rain, looking very nice. I like it. It's a nice tactical tactics sort of game, and it's got some interesting concepts. Like this cloning mechanic, siphoning ATMs, the whole economics behind everything. Researching, it's cool. I like it. Anyway. That's my encounter with Satellite Rain. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you got a nice glimpse of the game, and go check it out if you like. And that's I'm gonna wrap up here and under this the black annex, which is it's another one of those sexy places, I guess. All right, so that's the end of my Satellite Rain encounter. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.